يَا أَيُّهَا النَّاسُ قَدْ جَاءَكُمْ بُرْهَانٌ مِّن رَّبِّكُمْ وَأَنزَلْنَا إِلَيْكُمْ نُورًا مُّبِينًا.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. سبحانك لا علم لنا إلا ما علمتنا، إنك أنت العليم الحكيم. So this video is a result of a number of students asking me how these words are read in stopping in waqf. وَمَحْيَايَ وَإِيَّايَ مَثْوَايَ رُؤْيَايَ. So the following slide will give some ayat where these from the Quran where these words are found, and in this video I will discuss the correct way of stopping on these words.
يا عبادي الذين آمنوا إن أرضي واسعة فإياي فاعبدون. قل إن صلاتي ونسكي ومحياي ومماتي لله رب العالمين. يا أيها الملأ أفتوني في رؤياي إن كنتم للرؤيا تعبرون. قال معاذ الله إنه ربي أحسن مثواي.
So let's look at a definition of ya mutakallim. It's an attached pronoun for the first person found at the end of nouns, verbs and particles. For the riwayah perhaps it's read with sukoon and fatha. And it's found in jar or nasab state. So when it's in jar state, for example, it would be the mudaf ilay, such as in kitabi and ni'mati. And when it's in nasab state, it would be the mafa'ul bihi, such as in fa'iyaya. Another name for ya mutakallim is also ya idafa, so it's the same thing. And to know whether it's a ya mutakallim, it can be replaced by kaf or ha, the dhamirs kaf and ha. So for example, you can say kitabuka instead of kitabi, and kitabuha or kitabuhu instead of kitabi. So an example of ya mutakallim in a noun, verb and particle. So we have the particle here in innani. So here the ya mutakallim is preceded by nun al-wiqaya. And hadani, past tense verb, again it's preceded, the ya mutakallim is preceded by nun al-wiqaya. And rabbi, which is a noun, preceded, so here the ya mutakallim is found in a noun. So قُلْ إِنَّنِي هَدَانِي رَبِّي إِلَى صِرَاطٍ مُسْتَقِيمٍ. So say, indeed, as for me, my Lord has guided me to a straight path. So all the words mentioned in the first slide end in ya mutakallim and are preceded by a sakin letter. So for the words wa'iyaya and fa'iyaya, this is a dhamir munfasil, which means it's a separated pronoun, which is fixed upon fatha for the riwayat of hafs. For the word mahyaya, this is the exception where hafs reads it with fatha when it's not followed by lam ta'rif, hamzat al-wasl or hamzat al-qata'. Some recitations read this word with fatah and others read it with sukoon. This is a noun which is mansub due to inna, and the fatah is muqaddir, as the ya is the mudaf ilay. So the root of this word is ha ya ya. The next word is ru'yaya. Again, this is a noun which is majrur due to fi ru'yaya. And the ya mutakallim is the mudaf ilay. So this is an ism maqsoor, which means that words which have an alif maqsoor at the end, such as huda. So here the word ru'ya, the root is ra, hamza, ya. The next word, mathwaya, this is again, it's a noun. The root letters are tha, waw, ya. And this is the mafa'ul bihi, which is mansub bil fat with fatha, which is muqaddar. And the ya mutakallim is mudaf ilay. So we're including two more words which are found in the Quran. So we have the word asaya, which means my stick. Again, this is a noun. The root is ayn, sad, waw. And the ya in asaya is the mudaf ilay again. Most reciters read it with fatha on the ya. Some reciters, however, do ibdal of the alif into ya, and then they do idgham of the ya into ya mutakallim. And some read it with kasra on the ya, and some with sukoon on the ya. So there's a different ways between the recitations on the word asaya. Also included is the word hudaya, found in two places. So this is again, it's a noun. The root is ha, dal, ya. And this is again, it's a mafa'ul bihi, and the ya is mudaf ilay. So in all these places, you'll find that the ya mutakallim is preceded by an alif, a sakin letter, and Hafs reads all of these places with fatha. So the ya mutakallim in all of these words is fixed upon fatha in wasl. So how do we stop on these words? So waqaf is with mad arid li sukoon 2, 4, or 6 harakat, and the advanced student would need to say that waqaf is with sukoon mahad 3 ways, 2, 4, or 6. So we stop on the ya mutakallim with sukoon, and the alif which is found before the ya mutakallim is the letter which is lengthened 2, 4, or 6 harakat. And common mistakes are to either miss the ya in stopping, or to give it some kind of shadda, or to make it similar to a lean letter. So stopping would be fa'iyyay, wa'iyyay, wa'mahyay, ru'yay, mathway, asay, huday. So be careful you don't miss the ya, such as ru'ya, and don't make it into a shadda, ru'yay, and don't make it into a lean letter, ru'yay. So be careful that waqaf is done correctly on these words. The reciter also needs to be careful about the type of waqaf that they do. So waqaf on these words, except for mathway, will be in a testing situation or in an involuntary stop. So mathway, in this here we have a jayz stop. So here the reciter is allowed to stop on the word because of the silly. Innahu rabbi ahsana mathway. Subhanaka Allahumma wa bihamdik. Ashhadu an la ilaha illa ant. Astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk.
Wa an atlu al-Qur'an. فمن اهتدى فإنما يهتدي لنفسه ومن ضل فقل إنما أنا من المنذرين